Hi everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel Dr. Srinivas Medical Concepts and my FB page Dr. Srinivas Concepts. This is Dr. Srinivas, neurologist from Andhra Pradesh, India. I am also the medical author of the book Focused Neurology. Today we are going to talk about a very basic topic but important topic, the hypertonia and its various types. The hypertonia. Tone is defined as the resistance offered by the muscles to passive movements. So tone is the resistance offered by muscles to passive movements. Tone can be hypertonia, a decreased tone, which we see it in cerebellar lesions or lower motor neuron lesions, and an increased tone, which is known as hypertonia. So we'll see what is hypertonia and what are all the types of hypertonia. So an increase in tone is known as the hypertonia. Basically, there are two types of hypertonia. One, the rigidity, two, spasticity. Rigidity and spasticity. Rigidity is present because of the lesions of basal ganglia. That is the extra pyramidal system. Whereas spasticity is because of the lesions of the corticospinal tract. That is pyramidal tract. So rigidity is due to extra pyramidal involvement and spasticity is due to the pyramidal involvement. The second important point is that the rigidity affects all groups of muscles equally, both the agonist and the antagonist. So rigidity affects both the groups of muscles equally, agonist and antagonist. Whereas spasticity, the increase in tone is seen in anti-gravity muscles, that is the flexors of the upper limb and the extensors of the lower limb. The tone is increased in the flexors of the upper limb and the extensors of the lower limb, and therefore in a person who is having a corticospinal tract lesion, pyramidal tract lesion and hemiplegia, he's got a characteristic gait known as the circumduction gait, wherein he flexes the upper limbs and extends the lower limb. The flexion of the upper limb is because of the increase in the tone in the anti-gravity muscles, namely the flexors of the upper limb and the extensors of the lower limb. Therefore, he flexes the upper limb, extends the lower limb. When he walks, he cannot flex the knee, and therefore to clear off the ground, he has to encircle like this and walk. This is known as the circumduction gait, very characteristic of hemiplegic lesions, especially due to the corticospinal tract involvement. It is because of spasticity, wherein the tone is increased in anti-gravity muscles, that is the flexors of the upper limb and the extensors of the lower limb. Another important point to differentiate between the rigidity and spasticity is that rigidity is equally present throughout the range of the movement. So it is velocity independent. Whether it is the initial stage or final stage, the rigidity is present equally through the entire range of movement. Whereas in spasticity, it is velocity dependent. Initially, it is difficult to overcome. But once we overcome it, it becomes easier then to follow it up. So spasticity is velocity dependent, whereas rigidity is velocity independent. The velocity independent rigidity can be compared to lead pipe rigidity. We all know the lead pipe. The lead pipe, equally we can bend it throughout the entire range of motion equally. It is equally difficult or equally easy to bend the lead pipe. So it is compared with the lead pipe. Whereas a spasticity is compared to the clasp knife. Clasp knife spasticity. Initially, it is difficult to overcome, but once it is overcome, it becomes very easy. So spasticity is compared to the clasp knife. Clasp knife spasticity. And obviously, the rigidity will have the other extra pyramidal signs also. For example, if it is Parkinson's, they have tremor, rigidity, akinesia, and postural disturbances. Especially in Cogwheel, the lead pipe rigidity is superimposed with tremors. So it gives a catchy type to the lead pipe rigidity. It is catchy in the entire movement. So we call that as cogwheel rigidity. So left pipe rigidity with superimposed tremors, we call that as cogwheel rigidity. In spasticity, there will be other signs of femoral tract involvement, namely an increased deep tendon reflexes, and there could be Babinski sign. So these are all the important 5 differences between the rigidity and spasticity. So if we know the differences, we can easily place the lesion and helps in the neurological diagnosis. I hope you have enjoyed listening to my lecture. If you have any suggestions or comments, kindly post on to my YouTube channel. But please like and subscribe my YouTube channel, Dr. Srinivas Medical Concepts, and my FB page, Dr. Srinivas Concepts. Thank you. Bye.